The Raiders moved to 3-0 after beating the Dolphins in overtime at home. And I mean, 3-0, it just has such a nice ring to it. Who would have thought the Raiders would be 3-0 after coming off a pretty disappointing last season? And right now we're first place, tied first place in the AFC West with Denver. But the difference is we've played a lot better teams than Denver has. And Dolphins, they're not a great team. They didn't have Tua. Brissett didn't do terrible though, and they made things interesting. I thought we might lose this, and I'm gonna be completely honest, this wasn't really a great game for us. It's great we won, but the way the game went, it could have been a lot better. We had a lot of miscues, problems, a pick six, car through. It just wasn't, the most clean game per se, but it was a win. So I'm gonna take that 100%. I was at the A's game today, and I had to watch the whole game on my phone. So it was definitely an interesting experience. But yeah, the Raiders eked out the win in overtime too. So definitely a interesting outcome. So yeah, they moved to 3-0 on the year, and yeah, they're the first team to go undefeated in three games to open the season against teams that won at least 10 games the previous year, which is an interesting statistic, which further proves that I think the Raiders are the real deal. And obviously we played the Dolphins last year, and it was an unfortunate outcome that we lost on, kind of like the last sort of drive. But yeah, the first quarter, the Dolphins defense came out pretty good. Kenyon Drake started for Josh Jacobs. He's injured, obviously, and Peyton Barber did great too at running back. Carr threw a pick six, however, a little bit later on, which was unfortunate. He returned it. Landon Roberts picked off the pass, returned it for 85 yards. It wasn't really Carr's fault. I'm not going to put all the blame on him. I mean, the Foster Moreau kind of, didn't really run the route. Malcolm Brown, however, the former Ram, a little bit later, got a run all the way to the end zone. So it was 14-0. But the Raiders would get a bunch of unanswered points. Eventually, they were able to, get a safety on defense, which was pretty good to see. Defense last year was a liability, and right now, a safety. Who would have thought we got that? Pretty sloppy play for the Dolphins. They had got the ball back, and then we stopped them. So we got the ball back and 2 points. It was 14-2. Then the Raiders were able to get a field goal, 14-5, and then later with a touchdown, 1 yard touchdown to Ingold, it was 14-12. So, at half, I'm feeling a lot better than I was before. And then the Raiders kind of just, took control of the game from then on until a little bit later. It was 19-14. They got another touchdown. Renfro got it, a nice short touchdown. Ruggs had a good game as well. So did Waller. I was pretty happy with that. Then the Raiders got another touchdown. Barber went over the pile, and it was 25-14. Daniel Carlson did miss the extra point, which was pretty problematic because that made it, still a, after the field goal the Dolphins got, it was still a one score game, which was kind of annoying because that really what happened, that's how overtime was forced. They got a field goal, and then, eventually it was tied 25-25 right at the end of the game. Miami marches down the field. Trayvon Mullen gets a pass interference for the Raiders, and they get the 2-point conversion. It's 25-25. Then we go to overtime. Raiders won the toss. We've gone lucky with the toss. Two overtime games, we've won both tosses. We got down the field. We were only able to get a field goal, however, so the game wasn't immediately over. It was 28-25. And then Miami, they were able to tie the game up with a good drive from them. I mean, I got to give it to them. On 4th and 20, they were able to convert. And with a backup quarterback, that's pretty impressive. It was tied 28-28. Now then, Carr, was able to look to Waller deep on the first play of that drive. Byron Jones made a good pass breakup, however. And then, the Raiders had some penalties a lot too and injuries, which were, hurting them. But Bryan Edwards, who is emerging as a star for the Raiders, on a post route, Carr connected to him 34 yards. Then the Raiders kind of just killed down the clock. And Barber ran for 27 yards on the next play. Barber is great. I mean, if Jacobs is out for the foreseeable future, I think Barber's the way to go. Never even heard of him before this year. And look at him now. The Raiders get the field goal and win it. But that missed extra point was pretty important because it probably wouldn't have had overtime. But anyways, I'm happy. I'm happy. The Chiefs lost too. Who would have thought the Chiefs are last place in the division, the AFC West? Chargers won. Of course, Denver won. They're playing the Jets. But we have the Chargers next week, and that's going to be a big challenge. They're a pretty decent team this year. I'm not going to go as far as to say good because we've only been 3 weeks in, but we'll see what happens. So anyways, guys, let me know your thoughts. 28-31, the Raiders win against Miami. Good victory. You know, sloppy game, but you know, a win is a win. So, you know, just win, baby. I'll see you guys later. And yeah, go Raiders.